One of the oddest things that happened to me was the effects of getting really ill on my work and my ideas. It was in 1995, I got flu. You know, one of those flus that you're not terribly ill, so you have to stay in bed. You sort of feel lousy, but if you're like me, you keep going and keep going. So I went to bed and got up and went to bed. And in the end, I went to bed and couldn't get up. And I got post-viral fatigue or ME or whatever you like to call it. And I was in bed for, really solidly in bed, without being able to get up at all for about 6 months, and then gradually got better. And during those 6 months, I couldn't walk. I mean, I could just about get to the loo, but I couldn't go out, obviously. I could talk a bit, but I couldn't talk on the phone or use the computer. I couldn't do any of my work. Fantastic, cancel all your work, just do none. But I could read a bit. I could read for 15 minutes or so, and then lie and stare at the ceiling for half an hour, and then read a bit more. And I got this big stack of books, I always do, you know, books I must read today. And so, terrific, you know, I'll pick one of those. And I picked Dan Dennett's book, which had just come out then, Darwin's Dangerous Idea. Fantastic book, great, thick, fat book. I read it slowly, cover to cover, and much of it again and again. And in there, I found the idea of memes. Now, I'd come across this idea before and never noticed it, but this time it really affected me. The term meme was invented by Richard Dawkins at the end of his best-selling 1976 book, The Selfish Gene. What he did in that book was to explain the idea that was then becoming popular in biology, that evolution is happening not for the sake of the species or even for the good of the individual, but is really for the sake of the selfish genes. It's all about selfish genes competing with each other, and the ones that are successful shape the world.